In Jesus' name, good morning. Welcome to worship this day as we continue through this Epiphany season, the season of Revelation. Each week we see a different aspect of Jesus in the scripture readings. Among the announcements, please keep an eye on the Weekly Piper for ongoing and upcoming ministries. Thanks to the task force that worked earlier this week to take down all the Christmas decorations and store them appropriately, your efforts are very much appreciated for us. With those announcements, let us turn to our order for worship, and I invite those who are able to please stand. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who makes all things new, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Holy One, source of our renewal, we confess that we are wrapped up in sin and cannot free ourselves. We have not practiced your righteousness. Our hearts have turned away from you. For the sake of the world you so love, forgive us that we may be reconciled to one another for the glory of your holy name. Amen. Thus says our God, the former things have come to pass, and the new things I now declare. God's mercy makes us new. We are forgiven in the name of Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Dearest Jesus, at your
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the refining fire of the Holy Spirit, and the peace of God, which surpasses understanding, be with you all.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Be with you. Let us pray together. Holy God, our strength and our Redeemer, by your Spirit hold us forever, that through your grace we may worship you and faithfully serve you, follow you, and joyfully find you, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Our first reading comes from the 49th chapter of Isaiah. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you peoples far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." But I said, "I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God." And now the Lord says, "Who formed me in the womb and his servant to bring Jacob back to me, and that Israel might be gathered to him? For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength." He says, "It is too light a thing that you should be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob, and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel and his Holy One, to one deeply despised, abhorred by the nations, the slave of rulers. Kings shall see and stand up, princes, and they shall prostrate themselves, because of the Lord who is faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you." The word of the Lord. Our psalmody comes from Psalm 40. I waited patiently upon the Lord, who stooped to me and heard my cry. The Lord lifted me up and set my feet upon the high cliff, making my footing sure. The Lord put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many shall see and stand in awe, and put their trust in the Lord. Happy are they who trust in the Lord. They do not turn to enemies. Great are the wonders you have done, O Lord my God. In your plans for us, none can be compared with you. Oh, that I could make them known and tell them, but they are more than I can count. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire. You have opened my ears for offerings, sin offerings, if you are tired. And so I said, "Here I am, I come. In the scroll of the book, it is written of me. I love you, your will, O my God." I proclaimed righteousness in the great assembly. I have not restrained my lips. O Lord, you know. Faithfulness, deliverance. I have not concealed your steadfast love, truth, and great assembly. You are the Lord. Do not withhold your compassion for me.
May your steadfast love and
truth. The second reading is from Paul's letter, first letter to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God and our brother Sosthenes, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be his saints, together with all those who in every place call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, both their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give you thanks to my God always, for you because of the grace of God that has been given to you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind. Just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of the Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
According to St. John, the first chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and declared, "Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, 'After me comes a man who ranks ahead of me because he was before me.' I myself did not know him, but I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel." And John testified, "I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it remained on him. I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, 'He on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit.' And I myself have seen and have testified that this is the Son of God." The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples. And as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Grace to and peace from God our Father, our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, in communion with the Holy Spirit. Amen. There's a song by the Irish rock band U2 that begins with these words: "I've climbed the highest mountains, I've run through the fields, only to be with you, only to be with you. I've run, I've crawled, I've scaled these city walls, only to be with you. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for." Jim Somerville, pastor of the First Baptist Church in Richmond, Virginia, begins a sermon with reference to that song and suggests that that song has haunted an entire generation because it makes them wonder, "What about me? Have I found what I'm looking for?" It probably hunts young people the most, the 20-somethings among us, because they are the ones who are most actively searching for three things: a person, a place, and a position. What are you looking for is the same question Jesus puts to the two disciples that were following him. As John tells in his gospel, John the Baptizer is teaching in public, telling the crowds that there is one coming after him whom he does not know, which seems odd, because last week when Jesus was baptized, John recognized him. But perhaps time has passed and John has forgotten. That happens to some of us, doesn't it? And doesn't recognize Jesus. There's the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. And the two disciples, one of whom is Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, goes with the other disciple and follows Jesus. In his sermon, Pastor Somerville shares a story of talking to another local pastor and said to the pastor, "How would you feel if
I walked past and you were talking to a couple of your parishioners and you said to them, there's Pastor Jim Somerville of the First Baptist Church of Richmond, Virginia. And your two members turned and began following me to our church. The pastor admitted he wouldn't feel very good about it. We pastors still use that metric of numbers to measure our worth, unfortunately. And I too have fallen into that trap. It still hurts when I find that people have left Trinity to attend somewhere else, but then I remind myself that just as I was called here, so are you. And just as one day I may be called away from here, so may you. Because you see, this is Christ's church. He's the Lamb of God who gave himself for us. I didn't. Jim Somerville didn't. Try as we might, it still would work because we already have a Savior, Jesus the Christ. What are you looking for? Well, most of us are looking for something. We don't always know what we're looking for. Sometimes what we're looking for actually finds us before we find it. Jesus finds us even as we seek to find him. When 19-year-old Catherine Curd attended the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl on New Year's Eve, to support her brother who plays for the Ohio State Buckeyes, she got more than she bargained for. By the end of the game, she would be known to millions as the Peach Bowl Girl. Catherine, a freshman at Xavier University in Cincinnati, studying biomedical sciences in hopes of becoming a veterinarian, was sitting in the stands with family and friends, watching as the Buckeyes prepared a 50-yard field goal attempt that would, if successful, give them a 2-point victory over the Georgia Bulldogs. In the last moments of the game, which resulted in a 42-41 victory for the Bulldogs, when the field goal attempt failed, ESPN cut away to Gerd's face in the stands. The 3-second shot ended up on TikTok, and by the end of the evening had 4 million views. That night at the bowl game when we lost, I got so many texts saying I was on TV, like, this is awesome, I had no idea. And the next morning, like, this TikTok video blew up about me, and I was just so confused as to why, Gerd said. I didn't think that being on TV for a quick 3 seconds would put me in that position. Gerd found her Peach Bowl Girl nickname to be pretty funny, and that her newfound viral fame has been a complete shock. She told Fox News her family at first didn't know how to react to it, but now they're enjoying the moment, saying it could be a good opportunity for me. In the meantime, Catherine hopes to use her newfound fame to support women's athletics. She is a member of Xavier's inaugural women's lacrosse team and STEM education for girls. What are you looking for? Sometimes we know and sometimes we don't. And sometimes we realize what we're looking for when it finds us. Where are you staying? Come and see. They want to spend time with Jesus, and who doesn't? Abide with him. Throughout John's gospel, that word abiding pops up quite often. I'm the vine, you are the branches, abide in me, Jesus says. He invites us again to come and see. That's why we're here this morning. We know at least in part that whatever we're looking for Jesus, who finds us and invites us once again to come and see. And soon he'll invite us to his table, to nourish us with his own body and blood, to strengthen us for the living of these days. What are you looking for? There's a African-American spiritual that's actually in our With One Voice, and it answers that question, what are you looking for? In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise.
us. Give me, Jesus. Give me, Jesus. You may have all the rest. Give me, Jesus. And when I come to die, oh, and when I come to die, oh, when I come to die, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, you may have all the rest, give me Jesus.
Whether those two disciples knew it or not, it seems to me that's what they were looking for. And isn't that what we're all looking for? Give us Jesus. And he does. Amen.
All hail to you, O blessed morn, to tidings long by prophets born. Fulfillment you have given, O greatest and most blessed day. By dying, dearly buying our
Let us now profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Called together to follow Jesus, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Put a new song in the mouth of your church. Inspire the baptized to tell of your faithfulness, sharing the good news of your salvation throughout the earth. Bless the witness of missionaries in this country and around the world. Merciful God, receive our prayer. The waters of baptism call us into life in the Spirit. Preserve the world's waters. Protect them from pollution. Support plants and animals who depend on them. And bring rain to places of drought. Guide us in protecting local waterways, especially those here in the center region, and in responding to devastating floods, especially those occurring in California and the West Coast. Merciful God, receive our prayer. In Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Show your mercy to all nations. Direct leaders to do your will. Fill governing bodies with righteousness. Equip judges with discernment and compassion. Merciful God, receive our prayer. You incline your ear to all who cry to you. Draw near to individuals and communities suffering violence, injustice, illness, or poverty. Hide them in the shadow of your hand and make us signs of your faithfulness to all in need. We pray especially for Jerry, Jean, Jeff, Barbara, Brenda, Linda, Dee, Rita, Chris, Carla, Charlie, Eileen, Brian, Rich, and those we name now aloud or in our hearts. Merciful God, receive our prayer. You are glorified in the servants you have called. With Martin Luther King Jr., give us bold trust in you, even when it feels like a sharp sword or polished arrow. Give us courage to receive your call to repentance and racial justice. Merciful God, receive our prayer. In every place and time, you have sanctified your people. We praise you for the testimony of those who have died in the faith, especially those most dear to us. Strengthen us as we wait for the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Merciful God, receive our prayer. We bring to you our needs and hopes, O God, trusting your wisdom and power revealed in Christ crucified. Amen. You may be seated.
Let the vineyards be fruitful, Lord.
Thank you.
Brim our cup of blessing, gather a harvest from the seeds that were sown, that we may be fed. We may be fed with the bread. And the dreams of all, unite them with the prayers we offer now. Grace our table, our presence, and give us a foretaste of the feast to come.
Let us pray.
Liberating God, you break the bonds of injustice and let the oppressed go free. Receive these offerings in thanksgiving for all your works of merciful power, and shape us as people of your justice and freedom. You we magnify and adore, through Jesus our Savior. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come and taste the joy of God.
Let us eat and live.
As we gather for the meal, as you come to the altar, please pick up a glass from the tray on your left, using the other tray for used glasses. Let us gather for the feast. The congregation, please stand. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his love and grace. Amen. Holy One, we thank you for the healing that springs forth abundantly from this table. Renew our strength to do justice, love kindness, and journey humbly with you. Amen. The God who faithfully brings forth justice and breaks the oppressor's rod, bless, strengthen, and uphold you today and always.